Today's review video is for some Panart products. I've got two brushes to look at and also this lovely handmade deckled edge paper. Okay, this is going to be this one, which is synthetic size 6 and another synthetic actually, this one, and that's a size 0. But what's different about them apart from the size, obviously? Well, this particular one, which is a series, trying to find the series, 1102, which is my make out on the handle there, is a densified wood handle. In other words, it's really, really hard. So it's extremely hard compared to normal wooden handles, which means it can also last a long time as well. It's got a chrome plated ferrule on the end, and to be honest with you, it's got a very upmarket look as well. You know, these retail, this particular size, at the moment, retails around about the £6.50 mark. So not a cheap brush for something of this size, not for size 0. This particular one is their campus range, and it's a size 6 Panart 5501 gold synthetic. Wow. With a lovely red stained handle, as you can see, nickel-plated brass ferrule, which is quite nice. Gives a nice kind of royal look, doesn't it, on there. And like the other one, it's got a lovely shape as well, because it kind of billows out a little bit, as you can see there, towards the metal ferrule. So it kind of thins at the top, I guess wider and bigger as it gets towards that ferrule. So when you hold that within your hand, me being a lefty, or a righty for you, you find it's quite comfortable to hold as well. So I like the feel of that. It's not heavy either. You know when you get a heavy brush? I don't like a heavy brush, to be honest with you, and this is the same. So the price range tend to vary, and these tend to be about between £3 and £4. Depends on the size, obviously, that you buy. Now, the paper itself is a Panart paper, 200 grams. Now, 200 grams, I tend to use 300 grams. It's a little bit on the thin side for me, to be honest. However, it does say on their packaging, which is this one here, it does say this white deckled edge paper for sketch and watercolour. Handmade, acid-free, and it's a 200 GSM, and the size is 8.5 inches by 11 inches. Also, it's 100% cotton rag paper, and it's also made from recyclable materials as well, which is even better. So thumbs up, Panart, for doing that. And that also applies to that one as well, by the way, the woods that they use for their handles. Yeah, I know. All sourced from FSC materials. But they do quite a variety of ranges of brushes, as you can see here. But I'm not going to go through all that. If you want to pause the video, you can pause it literally now. And I'm going to turn it over again. And you can pause it again just there. Try that. And then there. Okay? So that's their little leaflet. And you can have a look at that yourself on that one. So the first thing you need to do with any brushes when you first get them is take off the plastic covers, which you've got there to protect the bristles. I always save them, by the way. They come in handy. They really do. Especially if you're transporting your brushes around. And the other thing as well is that you have sort of a water-soluble glue within the bristles here. So just bear that in mind. So you need to rinse these out thoroughly before you actually use them. They shouldn't take a lot of rinsing out, so I'm going to do that now, and then we'll give them a quick test show and see how well they perform. So, the first one, we're going to try out, let's get a bit of water on my palette there. We're going to try out the biggest brush first of all. As I mentioned, this particular one, this particular one is that series 5501. So we'll get some water, and we'll just completely load that with some very watery red at the moment. We'll try doing a bit of a squiggle line on this new paper, so I've never tried it before, and see how well it goes. You ready? Okay, here we go. Right, here we go. I'm going to apply the pressure, and I'm going to come off that pressure. I want to see how fine that tip will go on a fully loaded brush. So that's not too bad. Let's just continue that one down a minute. And then put the pressure back on again, and then back off. And you can just see the texture of the paper showing through there, can't you? It's just seeing the marks, the weave of the paper just coming through. I also want to see how well this paper kind of works, how well it's going to show this colour. Because some papers can make the colours look quite dull. So that's with a fully loaded brush. If I take some of that paint off the brush, just on some kitchen roll by the side of me, I want to see what it's like with a finer tip. Especially for this paper, I'm going to make it a little bit more of a milky consistency there. Okay, we'll try that. Just not too overloaded. Size 6, remember, so it's quite a large brush for me. I know, and it is a large, large brush. And you can get quite a reasonable line with this brush. But looking at this paper, if I take most of the paint off this brush line, if I graze the paper, I want to see if I can get a dry brush technique with it, which I can look. And now you can see the weave of that paper there. This 100% cotton rag recycled paper. Quite nice actually, isn't it? It's quite a standard pattern throughout the paper actually when you look at that. So really, it's not bad, is it? You know, the actual paper so far seems performing quite well. We'll find that out later on, because what I wanted to do with these brushes later, as I said, is have a play by painting a dog's eye painting. You know, that photograph just there, look. Let's now try to see how well it snaps back. So let's go for some blue for a change. This is phthalo blue. And let's just try drawing a line with that now and see how well it goes. So another squiggle line. I'm going to put the pressure on and then ease off that pressure. So when you apply the brush to the paper like so, how quick does it snap back in shape? So there was a spring on these bristles here. So how quick does that go back? And you can see, if I just do this a lot on camera, get a right mess here, I know. That springs back very, very quickly. And that's because it's synthetic. And I prefer synthetic for that reason as well. And now I've got a blue tinted nail. Oh, never mind. So the snap rate is really good on this. So I like something where it's got a good snap and springs back straight away. So really, this particular brush is a brush that I would use because of the snap rate, because it's synthetic and the way I tend to work with them. I know that some synthetic brushes don't hold the water as much as a sable brush would, you know, or quite as much water. So it won't quite go as long. So if I'm trying to draw a line all the way around here on a fully loaded brush, we'll see how quickly that runs out there. You see it's still going. I'm going upside down now. It's still going all the way and still going. This is, as I say, a fully loaded brush. You wouldn't think I'm an artist, would you? I know. Still going all the way around. I can't believe it's still going. This is really, really good. And now it's starting to go more of a dry brush kind of effect on there, as you can see. All right. So that's just about it. We're still going. I know. Just fast forward this a minute, shall we? And I think that will do. Still going. It's like a battery, isn't it? Still goes, you know. Okay, so that'll do. So considering that this one is a synthetic bristle brush, that's a mouthful, you can see how well it lasts as well. And you can also see it's got a very, very nice point. So yeah, thumbs up on this one, I think. My kind of brush, and it's not expensive either. Brilliant. Let's go for this one. The Panart Series. I can barely see that writing on there. 1102. Okay, we'll try that one next. So let's try a fine line with this first of all, shall we? Barely touching the paper. So two hairs in air, literally. And now I'm going to apply the pressure and it's breaking up on the surface. So there's not a lot of water holding property on this, but it is, as we know, a size zero. So we expect that anyway, don't we? Try a little bit more. Give it a tap. As you can see, it's just breaking up. It's not holding much in the way of paint. To be expected on such a small brush, though. If I fully load this brush with a more of a creamy consistency, let's try that one. Okay, apply the pressure, then come off the pressure. And again, it's breaking up on that paper surface, isn't it? So it's a nice brush and it holds lovely as well. It's got a lovely feel to it in your hand. And again, look at this. I'm not going to put paint on it this time around. Look at the snap rate on that lot and the way it snaps back from the tip of my finger. See what I mean? So it snaps really, really quickly. And again, that's because it's synthetic. You know, as for the paper itself, I'm not sure, you know, yet. I'm still not sure. I want to know, with this just being 200 grams, whether it could warp. Because it may warp, and if it warps, then it will need pre-stretching first. Let's have a look at the videos on YouTube. I've got one as well on how to stretch watercolour paper. I'll tell you what, I'll pop a little link to the top corner there for you, just out of interest. So just to sum it all up really, when I look at these two brushes, would I buy them? Yeah, I think I would actually. I'm not saying that because it's Panart or anything like that, but I think I would because they are quite nice brushes, really, and because they're synthetic, which I prefer anyway. Would I buy the paper? I'm not sure, because you can see, just by wetting that down there, I know it's still a little bit damp, but you can see how much that's warped on that paper there. So you would probably need to stretch the paper first of all. You know, and to me, unless you're working with a wet on dry technique rather than wet on wet technique, you know, this is going to warp quite badly. And then you'll end up getting rid of that deckled edge paper because of the fact you'll have to stretch it and tape it down. So if you're working, as I said, a wet on dry technique or working with normal pencil sketches or pen and ink, then I would go for this type of paper because it is handmade and it's 100% cotton, as we know. And also, we also know, even better, it's from recycled materials. Now, as I mentioned with these brushes, I'm going to paint a dog's eye, that little picture up there, look. And I'm going to use both the brushes and the paper, and we'll see how well I get on with that. So it's going to be quite interesting to see how well the detail goes on the paper. If you're watching this on catch up, we'll do it in a minute. So click on that link and I'll see you there very shortly.